Okay, so let's start with the error analysis today. So whenever you make a measurement, say for example you measured like last class we discussed using the Geiger scale, suppose you measure the length of an object to be 3.5 cm using a ruler, using a vernier caliper, suppose you got it to be 3.52. And using a screw gauge
3.28 3.5.
Suppose it is 3.52 C. Okay, so each instrument as you go down this list is giving you an extra precision. It's giving you more accurate answer about the length of that object which you measured. And the uncertainty of your measurement will be more or less?
Less.
It's getting lesser and lesser. So let's see how to calculate the uncertainty in each of these cases. So the first quantity which we can calculate is absolute uncertainty or absolute error. So absolute error is, in this case, when I mention like this, the last digit, the extreme right hand digit is the least significant digit. Okay? So this means that your measurement is greater than 3.4, less than 3.6. So it's 3.5 plus or minus 0.1. Agree? So the uncertainty is
0.1.
Plus or minus 0.1 centimeter. So this is the absolute uncertainty. So absolute uncertainty, do you understand now? It refers to the actual uncertainty in the measured value. The measured value lies between what interval, plus or minus what quantity. That is the absolute uncertainty of that measurement. So it depends on the instrument. So in the case of 1 year, what will it be?
0.01 centimeter.
And in the case of 2 years?
0.001 centimeter.
Okay. So now, to think that the best instrument to use is screw gauge when it comes to measuring length of small objects, because it has the least absolute uncertainty. But this does not give the full picture of error in a measurement, because it is possible to have a screw gauge and still it can end up as a hopeless instrument for our purpose. So how do we know whether this instrument is useful or hopeless for our experiment? Just by using absolute uncertainty, we can't come to a conclusion. I'll tell you why. The smallest length which you can measure with the screw gauge is how much?
0.001 centimeter.
So now, if I want to measure thickness of my hair or thickness of this line, I draw a line on the board. I want to measure the thickness of this line. So let us say the screw gauge. I use the screw gauge. Okay. Imagine I have a wire of this thickness. I use the screw gauge. Okay. Or let me draw using a pencil, very thin line. Okay. So using a screw gauge, when I do, let us say it tells me the value 0.002 centimeter. So the uncertainty in my measurement is how much?
0.002.
So it's 0.002 plus or minus 0.001 centimeter. So is this a good measurement?
No.
Can I continue using this instrument?
No.
Why not?
Percentage error is very.
Even though I did not explain what is percentage error, you are intuitively using that concept. Because the measurement is 0.002, but the error or uncertainty is 0.001. It's like saying
50%.
I measure the diameter of this marker pen and it is 1 centimeter plus or minus 1 centimeter.
And the error.
So that means it could be 0 centimeter, it could be 2 centimeter, then what's the use of this measurement? Agreed? So to quantitatively indicate whether a measurement is proper or not,
the instrument is proper,
we define something called as relative error. So relative error is, so if I have absolute error, it is denoted by delta x, where x is the measurement. If x is the measurement, the uncertainty is given by delta x
minus.
So relative error would be
delta x upon x,
where x is the mean value. You want, let me call it x mean.
mean or the real?
Mean or the measured value. If you have only one measurement value, then that measured value is x. If you have five measured values, then the mean of all those
and
five measured values
is the real value.
No, delta x is the absolute uncertainty.
So, okay. so
that means
it's the certain value, right?
Okay, wait, let me clarify something here. Absolute uncertainty can be obtained in two ways. It can be obtained as a precision of instrument.
The least one.
And it can be obtained as max minus min by 2 of multiple trials. Let me illustrate. Suppose I use my scale ruler and measured the length of the object as 3.5 cm. So my absolute uncertainty was 0.1 cm. Because the least count of my instrument was 0.1 cm. This is an example of precision of instrument giving rise to absolute uncertainty.
You, through this, you are getting that delta x, right?
Yes.
And
okay.
Delta x is absolute uncertainty.
Yes. So, we got it to be 0.1 cm in our example, where I measured 3.5 cm once using my instrument of ruler. This was using the ruler. Now, suppose I use the same ruler and again measure the length of the same object, but this time while making the measurement I was careless. I was talking to someone and I just measured like this from some angle. I introduced parallax error. So instead of 3.5, I measured it as 3.6 cm. All of you know, right, how parallax error
yes,
is caused
yes,
by looking at it from an angle instead of from above. Yes. Next time I measured it by talking to my friend on this side, like this. So now it became some other value. So let us see again. Next time, again, while measuring, I did some more careless mistake. This time it is again 3.6, 3.5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 trials I took. Due to my carelessness, I got 5 different values. So the correct value will be the mean of all these 5 values. So quickly do the mean. What do you get?
3.5
something. 3.5
years.
I want the exact value. Who took the
calculator?
So 3.55.
Yeah. 3.55. So 3.55. So let's do it exactly as the calculator gives you, so that you know exactly what to do in the exam. What does the calculator tell you?
3.52.
Read out all the decimal values. Now what is it? 3.54.
2.
3.52. So the mean, x mean, is 3.52. It doesn't give any more digits? Okay. So now, do you report the mean as 3.52 when you actually use your instrument which has
3.5.
Okay. So now, the question is, the answer is definitely you can't report it as 3.52 because your precision is not like vernier caliper. So if you report it like this, it means you used a measuring instrument which has precision up to second decimal. It means it lies between 3.51 and 3.53, but it's not true. So we have to round it off to one decimal. So if you round it off, anything if this digit is less than 5, you have to round it off by ignoring it. If it is equal to 5 or more than 5,
make it 6.
Increase it. Clear? So now it will be 3.5. But then what is the delta x? Delta x will be the maximum of all these. It is how much?
3.6.
Minus minimum is?
3.4
by 2. By 2. How much is this?
0.1. Sir,
so
what if you don't get 3.4? What if you just get 3.5? You don't get like 2 cut.
Okay. So coming to that. So suppose this had been 3.1. What would you get?
2.5.
Tell me exactly what you get, then we'll see what
happens.
Suppose you get 0.25. Now, absolute uncertainty should always be rounded off to one significant figure. Now I introduce a new term called significant figure. So significant figure means those figures which you know or you are confident about, your measurement gives you the right to use that figure. For example, when I took x mean, if I had reported as 3.5232, just because my calculator shows, these are called non-significant figures. They are not justified by your precision of your instrument. So you should not report it to these many digits. So you have to round it off till 3.5. So in this measurement, the number of significant figures is 2. Both 3 and 5 are significant. Okay. So we will get in detail about significant figures next.
Sir, so 0 is not significant?
No. In 0.25, 0 is not a significant figure.
We make it 0.3.
Wait. So now 0.25 is there. So what this means is my actual measured value is 3.5 plus or minus 0.25. If I report it like this. But when you know that this 0.2 itself will make it change from 3.5 to 3.7 or 3.3. The actual x could be between 3.3 and 3.7. So this first decimal digit itself is showing so much variation. What's the point of talking about the second decimal place? There is uncertainty in the first decimal place. What is the point of talking about second decimal place? Do you realize it? Do you get it? So there is no point to talk about second decimal place when the first decimal place itself is uncertain. So we will round it off to 0.3. Actually, there is a rule that if the number preceding 5 is even, you don't change it, you let it be. Somehow people have a hatred for odd numbers. It's a simple rule, convention followed all over the world. So 0.25 will be rounded off as 0.2. If it had been 0.35,
0.4.
It will be rounded off as 0.4.
Okay. So what is this logic?
I don't know the logic.
And if it's
0.5,
so
we should
odd numbers,
that's like 8 odd numbers. So with the change you want to see in the world, let's make it odd.
If possible, find out if there is any logical justification for this.
Let's change it right now, right now in India. So I have a doubt.
Wait, one at a time. So far, this is just a rule. Even I am not sure what is the logical explanation for this rule. I am assuming it's a convention. If anybody finds a logical justification, let me know. It will be something deep.
0.45 becomes 0.4.
Yeah. Yes, because 4 is even. By the way, last 1 year caliper class, we concluded by saying that Shaurya's method is correct but not logical, right? But that's not true. It's actually logical. After the class was over, only continues to let me.
Yes, sir, you sent us.
So you have to take the final absolute uncertainty as the bigger uncertainty of these two methods. That's what I was coming to.
So but how can we?
Let me summarize again. So what you do is, you have an instrument which has a precision which gives you some uncertainty, but then you use the instrument multiple times to take the same measurement that shows some uncertainty. Whichever is bigger of the two, that will be your final uncertainty in your calculation. Did you get what I'm saying?
Yes.
Okay, I will explain again. See,
you are of which two?
Listen. Ruler said the precision, due to the precision, answer is 0.1. When I took 5 measurements, my uncertainty is 0.25, max minus min by 2. So which is, so 0.25 is rounded off as
0.2.
Now tell me, out of this 0.2 and 0.1, which is bigger uncertainty?
Bigger 0.2.
0.2? So I will finally report my answer as 3.5 plus or minus 0.2 centimeters. So if I want to use this length in some calculation of volume, I will report it like this.
So but why don't we take the least?
Because actually the variation is so much. So you have to take this only, no?
Sir?
Which is the reality? Actually, when you took the mean value, it is showing a variation
so
of
the
point.
So the precision of instrument is given, like you don't.
Even though instrument is precise, my method of measuring is not precise. It is creating more error. So my final measured result has more error.
Sir?
So either improve your technique of measuring. See, it could be like you are making the measurement in a moving bus. And the bus is constantly shaking. So each time you take the measurement, your value changes. You can't help it.
So you take the most absolute uncertainty.
Yes, whichever absolute uncertainty is a bigger sir. Value, that will be the value which is taken.
Sir, from the second formula, maximum minus minimum by 50, that gives you uncertainty only. Right?
Yeah.
And so we have to use both the formulas to find out the exact value.
Yes, whichever is the bigger value. Now Raghav asked this question, what if this is zero? So suppose I took 5 trials, all 5 trials it gave me 3.5, 3.5, 3.5. It will, right? If
yeah.
I take a scale and measure right now, it will give me same value all 5 times. So max minus mean by 2 is 0.
So
now my uncertainty will be the ruler's uncertainty,
0.1.
Whichever is the bigger. Clear till now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now absolute is clear. Now let's discuss relative uncertainty. So relative uncertainty concept is required to decide which instrument to use for our experiment, whether it's appropriate or not. So in this example, okay, all these three cases, let us see what is the relative uncertainty of this measurement. So ruler example.
0.1
by 3.5 into 4. Just that. So this is called relative error. And percentage uncertainty is denoted as percentage UC. That is relative error into 100.
1 by 35.
Relative error, let me call it RE. So RE multiplied by 100 is percentage uncertainty. So 0.1 by 3.5 into 100.
Can you explain relative error?
Can you explain relative
error? Relative error is the actual uncertainty in my measurement divided by the actual measured value. What it tells you is what fraction of my measured value is the error. Suppose I measure the thickness of this menace 1 centimeter. My uncertainty is also 1 centimeter. So what is 1 by 1 into 100?
100%. 100%.
So the uncertainty in my measurement is 100%. That means, yeah.
Koi fayda
hi nahi hai is measurement ka.
Whereas,
if the uncertainty was 0.5, and my measured value is 1 centimeter.
50%.
So 0.5 by 1 into 100? 50%.
That means jitne significant figures zyada increase
the lesser the answer.
Percentage uncertainty is 8 to 100.
Yes.
So better the percentage error, less the percentage error, better the instrument.
So, yes.
So we
for
can
our
see,
use.
So,
for our use.
So we can say it like this also that promote the length. The
exactly. So the same instrument with the same absolute uncertainty will give a better measurement if you measure a bigger quantity. That's why whenever you use a voltmeter or ammeter, suppose your voltmeter has a range of 0 to 1 ampere. Okay. And it has these divisions. So least count is 0.1 ampere. Let's say. Okay. Will you use this instrument to measure a current of 0.1 ampere?
No.
Then your relative error is very high. Because its smallest division is 0.1 ampere and you are using it to measure one division, 0.1 ampere. So percentage uncertainty is?
So what will be the right current?
The right current will be something more than the halfway mark.
So
some current in this region you can measure properly.
0.6,
0.6. Yeah. So the relative error should be less. Say less than 5%.
So I think
what?
Chadi.
No,
but it is recording, right?
Yeah.
It will record. Okay. So one point to remember is any instrument has a range of measurement. Any instrument has a range of measurement. You should always make sure you use it within the higher end of the range, not in the lower end. Because only then the relative uncertainty will go less. Percentage uncertainty of the measurement will be less. So I can use a scale, a ruler, to measure length of this cable. The relative uncertainty will be very less. But if I use it to measure diameter of the pen, the relative uncertainty will be more. So it's not appropriate. So yes, you should move on to vernier caliper instrument.
0.1 by 3.5 is fine.
Yeah. So what is the percentage error? 0.1 by 3.5. How much is this? Calculate and tell me.
2.857.
So 2.8%. That's okay, acceptable.
Second, 2.857.
Less than 5% is acceptable. Here we just need to estimate in percentage, right?
No, like decimal is in percentage also do you have to take in account the significant digits of the
Yeah, you can. So here one significant figure is the least, so round it off to 3%.
Sir?
Yes.
So but in as you just said that you know it should be on the higher range of the thing. So if I take 0.6 ampere, if I measure 0.6 ampere and using the percentage uncertainty, then it comes to 33.33%. So you just said that lesser than 5 is good.
So use an instrument which is having a final a lesser least count, which has a range of 10 amperes.
So I say good.
That's the message.
Which
so 1 ampere ammeter with only 10 division is a bad instrument.
So 10 ampere with 0.1 ampere.
That would be better. Yes.
Which fixed rate keep this much percentage error we can use the instrument?
5% is ideal.
Above that.
Yeah. Ideally. But you have to work within your limitations. Whatever instruments you have in your lab, you can use only that. So what you can do is, you can report your measurement with that uncertainty. You can say, my absolute uncertainty, my percentage uncertainty is this much percent. So within that, so it will affect your result. Your result will also have correspondingly more uncertainty. If percentage uncertainty of the initial quantity itself is 10%, your result will have maybe 50%, 60% uncertainty. So whatever you claim as your result, you have to describe it along with the percentage uncertainty. Yes.
So that is what happened last time when we tested, when we did the practical, the uncertainty was plus minus 1 centimeter.
So percentage uncertainty of measuring cylinder will be very high compared to percentage uncertainty of vernier caliper. Okay, so these three concepts are clear. Now let us see how to use them for calculations. So here I have written these are used for addition, subtraction, and this is used for
multiplication.
I erased it or what?
Yes.
Multiplication, division, and power.
Portion.
So let's see.
Question
and power. So let us see when we do calculations, how to that is called error propagation. Error propagation. So you measured some 3 or 4 measurements you took.
Yes.
Those quantities are used in some formula to calculate some new quantity, derived quantity.
Error.
Right?
Yes.
Huh? Suppose you measure length, breadth, height of a block, and you use it to calculate the volume. Okay. So suppose this has a percentage error of 3%, 2%, 4%. Percentage uncertainty of these three measurements. What would be the percentage uncertainty of my volume?
24.
Volume is LVH.
24.
These are the kind of questions. What?
9%.
You just multiply the percentage error. On what basis you arrived at that?
So n into p into h. So no. Multiply it down.
Sir,
9%. Sir, so I think that's the
delta.
Oh no,
that's delta V upon V will be delta L upon L plus delta V upon V plus delta L.
So when we had it, we multiplied it. So this time we'll add it.
Okay, now I have a question to ask you. do you need to do the derivations for the rules of uncertainty? It's actually not required.
Yes.
But it's required if you want to understand.
Yes, sir.
Or shall we just tell the rules and start applying the rules?
No, understanding, sir.
The derived upon 3 is equal to 3%.
Derived.
Okay, I will do the derivation of the easiest one. The harder ones you do.
Yeah.
The easiest addition subtraction I will do it for you. Multiplication you try to do on your own. Okay, so the logic or the thinking process in the derivation is the same. Okay, so this is one thing we want to find out. So let us say this is for product, right? We'll come back to it later. Let's first do addition.
Okay.
So suppose I have a quantity. Suppose I have a stick here. I use one more stick. Its length L1 is say 5.2 plus or minus 0.1 centimeter. And this L2 is 7.5 plus or minus
0.01.
Okay? So I am joining these two and making a longer stick. So this would be L. So what would be the length?
12.
So obviously I have to add these two lengths.
12.5.
So 5.2 plus 7.35 is how much?
12.5.
I'm just trusting your calculations. This calculator is
12.5.
So you can calculate. I am not used to calculating in my mind. So 12.55 centimeters.
So here if there are
no plus or minus
0.2.
What do you think we should do?
0.11.
The logic here is, this uncertainty will be the maximum possible value of L minus the minimum possible value of L by 2. Okay? So when will you get the maximum possible value of L?
0.0.
And this achieves maximum possible length.
Right.
And this also achieves maximum possible length. So what is the maximum possible length? So this is delta L1. This is delta L2. Agrees? So the maximum possible is when both the errors add up together. Agreed?
0.11.
Delta L1 plus delta L2. Plus this will be the total length. L1 plus L2.
12.6.
This is L max.
12.6.
Agreed or not? And what is the minimum value?
L1 plus L2
will be as usual.
Plus delta L
minus delta L
minus
delta L
point
B. Delta L1
minus delta L.
Minus delta L1 minus delta L.
This length is plus or minus this.
Oh, okay.
So if this error is in the negative side, this length will become shorter. And if this error is also in the negative side, this length will be shorter.
Yes, sir.
So if two shorter sticks are joined together, you will get as much
0.1
stick as possible. So this is the minimum. So the actual uncertainty is maximum possible minus minimum possible by 2. Agree?
Yes.
So do this.
Sir, we can also do by adding the delta.
L max minus L min.
Yes.
So basically,
subtract kar rahe ho
So it's delta L1 to delta L2.
So
it's delta L1 to delta
L2.
So this minus this when you do, L1 will cancel out?
Yes, sir.
What happened?
So minus the change plus minus over. So that
will
be twice.
Minus 2 minus is plus.
2 delta L1 2 plus
2. Hey sir, see the bracket with 2 dollars, 2 card though.
2 minus.
Okay, very same thing. So this by 2.
25.10 upon 2.
2 cut jayega.
25.10.4
So now you see we got the result, general rule. If you want to add two quantities, then the absolute uncertainty in your final calculated quantity of the sum
is delta L1 plus delta
L1. The sum of the individual uncertainties.
So but the proof. In that case, L1 will be plus.
Plus, so the final answer also will have an uncertainty because of that, right? So we want to derive a general rule which we can apply to find the final uncertainty if we know the individual uncertainty. Agreed? Now this general rule for all cases, whether you add, subtract, multiply, divide, take a power of a quantity, the most general rule is whatever quantity you are calculating, say y, is a function of x, y, z, y, p, q,
r,
x to the power a,
a, a b, c,
b, c,
d, e.
So all possible combinations are covered. A, b, c can be any number, positive, negative, fraction, anything. So if you are, so this covers all possible functions. Agreed? Product, division, everything.
Yes, sir.
So what rule should we use to find the uncertainty of y? What is the question? So the general rule which you can apply is, you put for each of these quantities x, y, z, p, q, the maximum possible value by adding the uncertainty to it. So it will give you, like put the combination in such a way that y becomes maximum. That means numerator terms should be maximized, denominator term should be
minimized.
So I have to take negative error in this, positive error in this.
So shouldn't all the terms be maximized
and then minus? So if you want to maximize
y,
you do bilkul
samajh
nahi aa
raha. Oh, okay. I have explained. Don't get why did you get so upset? If you don't understand immediately, it is a natural thing.
Answer that answer, what is the final answer
to
your right?
It will take multiple times to understand.
Can you write the final answer?
So basically we want the maximum uncertainty.
So whenever you want to find delta y is always equilibrium.
Okay.
If you want to discuss, you ask for some time, I'll give you time.
Wish.
Now discuss something urgently. Based on what you have
done,
but we have stopped it. I have no time. We have discussed something. What do you discuss?
But then,
uncertainty should be rounded off to one significant figure. There is no point of talking about second decimal.
0.1.
See, you round off 0.1 as 0.2.
Sir, आपने तो बात
की.
12.6 plus minus 0.1.
डेटा इसलिए हमारा
12.6. 12.6.
जो भी
plus minus 0.1. Imagine the length, the absolute length is 12.555. Then will the uncertainty always be 1 decimal or 2 decimals?
See,
if the actual
measure
value was
12.555,
no, based on this.
Time over.
Something
नहीं है.
If you didn't understand, you have to raise your hand immediately when you don't understand.
Absolutely.
I will explain again and then move on. So now, which part you are stuck?
So, I understood this example of India. There are two quantities, they are
okay, so now you follow from this moment and stop me.
Just use a simple example.
Just see here. Somebody asked if it is 12.555, what will happen? Right? If this was 12.555, but if the absolute uncertainty is 0.11,
so
I have to round it off to one significant figure.
Always?
Yes.
Okay.
Absolute uncertainty always round off to one significant figure. And then see how many decimal it is. It is only one decimal place. So I have to round off this value to one decimal place. Understood the logic? Everyone? Ab kya samajh gaya?
Ye aapne round off kyun kiya? आपने जो जो अलग अलग रूलर की मेजरमेंट की दोनों में अलग अलग सिग्निफिकेंट फिगर्स हैं.
Yes.
So sir, which one, which in the answer, how many significant figures you get?
Which is the smallest one?
That's the rule I'm teaching you. To find out your answer should be rounded off to how many significant figures. The process is, you have to add the uncertainty of each. You will get a total uncertainty. Round it off to one significant figure. Or we will end up in some decimal value. Round off your mean value to that many decimal place.
Hamesha jo bhi ho, hamesha one significant figure bhi round off.
Yes.
Sir, book mein likha hai, your value should be rounded off to the smallest significant numbers.
Which yeah. Here is 0.1. But both are one
significant figure.
Okay, what you are saying is 5.2,
L1, L2,
7.2. Yeah, I am saying this.
This is 2 significant figures, this is 3 significant figures. So your final answer is 8.1. It will not be wrong. Not
necessary.
So
what do you think is the
0.11.
The answer is
first rule, you understand, when you add a number, the absolute uncertainty of your answer is the sum of the individual uncertainties. Now if you subtract two numbers, what will be the rule?
Same rule.
Suppose I have a stick. Okay? I have one more stick.
Then you subtract it.
And then I say this is my cut off.
Kya kar raha
hai?
Okay, wait, how can I give a real life?
I'm just giving you a real life.